Word to Big Bird, Big Up Yourself, What's Happening, Word Up Brother.
What in the name of Jake Humphrey's eyebrows are you on about?
Well, we're hanging out with skateboarders and bike riders today, so I thought I'd give the viewers some of my street lingo that I've been working on, you get me?
Mark, Mark, Mark. Bike riding and skateboarding is not just about street lingo. Oh, no. It's far more exciting than that.
All right, then, Mr. I've been bike riding and skateboarding all my life. What actually is it about, then?
It's about this.
Fair enough.
Here's what else is coming up on today's show. There's a DSD storm brewing for one DSD-er.
Sam shaves his design for the first time, but will it be good enough to impress his mentor?
And the boys take on the girls at skipping.
All gripping stuff, but there is something else that's happening today. Something that I have complete control over. Ladies and gentlemen, for the first time on national TV, we will be unleashing the beast!
It's Thursday on DSD, and you know what that means, don't you?
Yeah, we get to unleash the beast.
Yeah, the beast.
The beast.
Yeah, we know what that means.
Yeah.
But it doesn't just mean that, does it, Mark?
Oh, no, I'll get to lick the spoon today.
No.
No. Oh, yeah, I'll get my award for our services to laundry.
No.
No. It's Thursday, isn't it, mate?
There you go.
Sorry.
Right,
we get dressed up as donkeys, we play board games.
No,
you know.
No, Mark, what are you doing? It's Thursday. Sam versus Mark Day.
Of course it is. I'm so sorry.
That's all right. You see, every Thursday, we will be choosing some winning teams to represent us from camps and clubs up and down the UK, hoping that that will give you some ideas of something you can do differently. They will battle it out till the end. And today's teams are from York.
Oh, it's ringing bells now, because at the end of the day, we're going to put these teams together against a common foe, the beast!
Right, that is it. What is this beast you keep talking about?
Follow me. This is the beast!
Whoa, what is that?
Now, to the untrained eye, this is a water balloon launcher. But to the H2O connoisseur, it's a sphere-accelerated altitude jet-powered rocket machine.
Sounds wicked. Can I have a go, please?
All in good time. All in good time.
Ever fancy doing something different? Well, now's your chance. This summer, DSD challenges you to get off the sofa and do something different, just like this lot. As well as seeing what you get up to, we're travelling the length and breadth of the country to have a go ourselves. And if you send us shots of your DSDs, you may even end up on the TV yourself. So log on to the website and get stuck in. Go on, do something different today.
Yeah! How you doing, man?
How are you?
Wicked. That was impressive. This is Sparrow, everybody. Mate, how long does it take to be as good as you?
Quite a while, but yeah, you just gotta have fun.
Yeah, man. How long have you actually been doing it for?
I've been doing it for like roughly 4 years now.
Wow, did
4 years? So, have you got any advice for anyone who wants to take it up for the first time in DSD?
Oh yeah, just go down to a skateboard shop, get a helmet, get some pads maybe.
Okay.
Get a skateboard, go down to the park, see if you like it, take it from there.
Wicked.
Brilliant. Well, if you fancy skateboarding for your DSD, then get on the website and tell us about it. bbc.co.uk/CBBC and click on DSD. Come on, I know that you want to be part of our whopping total.
And it is whopping, I can tell you.
It is indeed. Right, come on, it's challenge time. Gather around, everybody.
Here we go. It's Thursday. That means it's Sam versus Mark. Now, guys, we're playing for honour. Sam has no honour. And to be honest, it's quite bad, and I don't mean that in a hip skater type way. Let's meet the teams. Guys, what's your name?
George, Freddy, Tom, Del.
Yeah, he got it. Look at that.
Big fist. That's what he wants. He wants to win. That's what he wants.
You missed your team member on the end. Introduce yourself.
Ruben.
Already gonna lose, I think. All right, let's introduce my team. Go.
Sparrow.
Dan, Callum,
Ryan,
Wedgie,
Toby.
All right, now, at the end of the show, these two teams will merge to face...
The Bees!
And the winner will get that important place on the DSD leaderboard.
Where is he? What, he knows?
No, I'll tell you later.
Oh, OK, all right. Now, the group of people that have got the highest score at the end of the series will win this fantastic prize.
It's a brilliant prize.
Absolutely, that could be yours. Or up until we get a second series, then we'll probably have to take it back, sorry.
Yeah, sorry about that. Right, come on, no messing about now, it's time to do it.
It's coming.
Because
right.
The first challenge of the day is skateboard Skittles.
It's pretty simple. Two presenters, two skateboards, two sets of Skittles. Now, our team's gonna push us towards the Skittles, most Skittles there wins.
Okay, let's do this. All right, teams, get ready.
Ready.
Here we go!
Oh, yeah!
Okay. Let's do it, man. Let's DS do it. Oh, hey, up. Okay. Here we go. Right, okay. You ready, Mark?
I am more than ready. I'm ready.
Okay, hold on. Let me get. Okay, in three, yeah. Two, one, go!
Yeah.
Wow!
Are you ready? No! You're so cheating!
You're too far!
That's ridiculous!
I think that means that the red team have won the
first
challenge.
I think we should all calm down because there's still two challenges left.
That is true. Hey, good game. Now, though, it's time to get a DSD update with Aisha. She's at the DSD desk.
It's crazy paving.
Good morning. Well done, Sam, for the win. Mark, mate, you're just losing your touch. You're watching Do Something Different, and I'm here at London Science Museum, ready and rearing to go for another
DSD cast.
Yes, indeed. Now, you should already know by now that I'm here to give you all the latest DSD news that you need, so let's get straight to today's headlines. Now, Nathan in Manchester sent us in a picture of him trying out skateboarding as his DSD. Nice one, Nathan. Liking that. Now, according to our DSD site, one of the most completed DSDs is to try out trampolining, completed by over 550 of you, including Twin Purple, Katie Lee Forever, and also Tashay and Mr. Cameraman, apparently. So, well done for that. Now, in today's regional news, today's hotspot is shared by Sussex and Surrey, because combined you have done the most DSDs within the past 24 hours, so well done for that. But today's black hole is Leicester. You know what you need to do, Leicester? Get online, do a DSD, and make sure you get back to us so you can be counted, and you never know, we could be mentioning your name right here on DSD Cast. Now, I can't do all the stats all by myself. I need to have a co-presenter, and that is where Sophie comes in. Hello, Sophie, you all right?
Yeah, I'm well. Thanks, Aisha.
Good. Now, you did your own DSD, didn't you?
I did.
Well, let's take a quick look at it. You managed to get there in the end. You tried out drumming, didn't you? How'd you find it?
It was really good fun.
Good. Well, listen, if you want to be right here in the hot seat at the DSD desk, all you need to do is simply send in your video along with your contact details to this address. DSD PO Box 48369, London W12 7UZ. Coming up, more DSD stats, but for now, it's back to the boys.
Hey, it's good to see you. DSD's coming in thick and fast.
Yeah, we're going to do something different now. We're going to learn some gnarly skateboarding moves, aren't we?
Yeah, we're going to do some of this in a second.
Yeah, we're going to warm up first, though, aren't we?
Yeah, obviously we don't want to embarrass Sparrow or anything.
Yeah, so while we learn some gnarly moves, I suggest you watch another DSD and face a challenge that's going to be a storm.
Meet John. He's 11, he loves football, cars, planes, and mucking about with his mates.
I describe John as funny.
He lives with his mum, dad, and younger brother Charlie.
He's got a great personality.
He's mad.
I'm up for a challenge. Try anything like me and I'll do it, and I don't care.
Anything?
I wouldn't like to do things that are really boring and sitting down, example, for reading the news, doing the weather, and stuff like that.
What was that?
I wouldn't like to do things that are really boring and sitting down, example, for reading the news, doing the weather and stuff like that.
Oh dear. John's not going to like this then, because he's about to find out that his DSD challenge is presenting the weather live on television in front of over a million people.
Let's have it then.
There'll be highs.
Leave one lifting.
Yeah, left a bit.
And there'll be lows.
London's like degrees, about 24 degrees about in that height.
This is terrible.
John's about to get his DSD challenge. He and his family are off shopping, but little does he know that this TV shop literally has a surprise in store.
Ooh. Whoa, that's big.
Whoa. Hello, John. It's time for you to do something different. Your challenge is to learn to be a weather forecaster. In just 2 weeks' time, you'll replace me and present the weather live on BBC Breakfast to more than a million people. They'll all be relying on you to tell them if it's going to rain or shine. So good luck. See you at breakfast.
Oh my God.
Predicting the weather is never easy, but doing it in front of an audience of over a million viewers is an enormous challenge.
I was shocked. I didn't expect that it would be weather forecasting.
The mini tornado seemed to come out of nowhere.
It's not the first time John's had an unexpected weather experience. Last December, a tornado hit his part of London.
And we didn't really think it was a tornado. It just went all dark. And then lightning, thunder, and crashes. Oh, it was just one of the worst moments in my life, I think. Yet to be counted.
John's about to find out exactly what his challenge involves.
At 6 o'clock in the morning, we're about to go to the BBC to meet Carol Kirkwood. I'm pretty tired, but I think I'll get on the way during the day, so yeah.
Meet Carol. She's the weather presenter John will be replacing in under 2 weeks' time. She gets up early every morning to tell us whether the weather will be hot or not.
Now, what we have this morning across...
John has a real uphill struggle here because I've been a weather presenter here at the BBC for 9 years and I can tell you it is one of the hardest jobs I've ever done.
John's come to BBC Television Centre to find out more.
Hello, John. It's nice to meet you. Listen, I'm in a real rush just now because I've got a broadcast to do in about 5 minutes. I've got to go, but I'll catch up with you later.
OK.
OK, honey, see you later.
See you later.
Bye.
While Carol rushes off to present the weather, John is given a taste of what goes on behind the scenes.
Rundy. Camera three next, then Carol down the barrel, please. Next to three.
In just a few days, John will be standing exactly where Carol is, delivering a one-minute forecast live to over a million people. Her forecast over, Carol takes John down to the Blue Peter Garden to show him how it's done.
It's got a million doors, so I was like, is she going to do it? Is she going to make it? Am I going to make it on the day? So
you'll be looking at the camera.
As Carol prepares for her next forecast, John gets to see close up what life will be like on the other side of the camera.
He's dealing with a scientific subject, yet he has to put it across on television, so it's a tough challenge for him.
If John's going to successfully present the weather, he first needs to understand what he's talking about. So it's off to the Met Office in Exeter, the centre of weather forecasting in the UK, to meet top forecaster Rob McElwee.
Now, I believe your challenge is with Carol to broadcast live to millions of people and your friends and family and not sound like a dummy. Is that right?
Yeah, you'd be right.
All the BBC weather presenters are trained meteorologists, experts in the science of weather. So Rob gives John a crash course.
I never thought that they would take me into a classroom and give me like an hour's lesson on what they do. So I was pretty shocked when it happened.
To make sure John has taken it all in, Rob has laid on a little exam. So exactly how much has John managed to remember?
That's completely wrong. Seven. He's done surprisingly well today, but I still think if he's tired on the day, he's going to get caught out by not being able to recall what he's just put in his head.
While John may know a bit more about the science of weather, in order to help him with his TV challenge, he's now got to learn how to put it across. So it's off to the Royal Navy Air Base in Yeovilton to present the weather to a room full of pilots whose lives depend on accurately knowing the weather.
Really exciting. Let's get here.
Meet Tom.
Lieutenant Commander Tom Joyce, senior pilot of 815 Naval Air Squadron. When it comes down to it, the safety of our crews depend upon the accurate weather information. And they're going to be hanging on every word he says.
To show John just how important weather is to the pilots, Tom takes him for a ride.
And lifting. Lima 1 lifting.
The helicopter simulator is just like flying a real helicopter, but with one crucial difference. The weather is entirely under the pilot's control.
Okay, you can see the surface. We can't see what's ahead of us. This wasn't briefed at the foot of the Met brief, was it, this fog?
No.
So now we're now we're in trouble.
Tom, the guy I was with, he flew me around it first, and he said, John, it's your go. They gave us strong winds, and that kind of blew the helicopter around a bit. So, yeah, I had to fly through that in the front of me, then, like, the helicopter shake a lot. Then, like, rain, it's like, and it's really cold rain, so you have to flick on a thing called anti-ice.
And the one next to it.
So, yeah, it was a really fun experience. Woo!
Now that John knows just what's at stake, he's got to give a weather forecast to 30 pilots who are about to go flying.
Talking in front of about 30 people is a nerve-wracking thing, even if you're an expert.
He's only got an hour to prepare, exactly the kind of pressure that he'll be under when he presents the weather live on TV.
I'm really, really nervous. Because if I say it's going to be sunny, they go to sunny, there's suddenly gusty wind, they could knock the helicopter over and possibly kill someone.
He needs to make sure he's got it exactly right so our crews know what they can expect when they get airborne.
If I don't get it right, then I'm just off. Oh my God. I'm sorry.
Coming up on DSD, will John cope with the pressure of his first ever weather forecast? Will his presentation skills be up to the job?
8,000 to 12,000 feet, sorry.
And does Carol think he'll be ready for his final challenge?
This is real. This is not playing anymore. This is real.
Ooh, I can feel the pressure already. Find out how John gets on a bit later on.
Yeah, and if you fancy a laugh, check out Sam's exercise in improving his speed.
And another fried squid. Do me another plate exactly the same like that, please.
Okay.
Come on, mate. Bear. Let's go,
okay,
go, go.
Okay, okay.
Quickly.
Four. There you go.
Timing, I think.
Quicker.
All right, more from Lightning Hands Nixon a bit later on when he comes face to face with his DSD hairdressing challenge.
All
nice,
right.
Nice work.
Right. It's time for Sam versus Mark challenge part deux.
Right. Two?
Part deux. Oh, okay. Right. You know it. You know, you get to a skate park. Safety is the most important thing. But, Mark, what happens when it all goes a bit wrong?
Well, I'm guessing here, Sam, but I think we get two teams. We give them 30 seconds to put on as many safety pieces of equipment on a presenter or something.
That is brilliant. All right, Sparrow, come on in here, lad. You can be our independent adjudicator. Teams, are you ready? Brilliant. OK. In three, two, one.
Go, 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 go.
OK, here we go. That's it, lads, that's it. Come on. OK, anything can go in my arms. Okay, Sparrow, you need to look at both teams and give a fair judging.
Ooh, it's a tough one this time, yeah. Ooh, for sure. I don't know, like, you've got four items, we've only got two. Red win!
All right! Oh,
it's an absolute disgrace!
I mean, it's such a shame there's only one challenge left. You can't bring it back anyway at all. Oh, what a shame. It's time to find out who win in the boys versus girls skipping challenge. Bad luck, lad. Bad luck.
Today, we are talking about double dutch, and I'm not talking about clogs or Edam cheese. No, I'm talking about skipping, ultra cool skipping. Double dutch is acrobatic skipping involving two ropes and some seriously fancy footwork. Oh, I've had enough of that. Oh, check this out. Double Dutch was brought over to America in the 1600s by Dutch settlers. And when hip-hop was born in the 1970s, Double Dutch competitions became a part of early hip-hop culture. It's mega competitive. And speaking of competitive, I'm here in Warwick with two teams that reckon that they can run rings around the experts.
I'm Lucy and I'm 11.
I'm Hannah and I'm 10.
I'm Jessica and I'm 11.
And we're the girls!
I'm Alex and I'm 11.
I'm Josh and I'm 10.
And we're the boys!
Now, neither of our teams have ever done any double dutch skipping before, but are you guys ready to give it a try?
Yeah!
What? That was a bit lame. Are you guys ready to give it a try?
Yeah!
We've met the teams. Let's find out a little bit more about today's experts. Sophie, Nicole, Bobby and Tasmin are part of the Blue and White Rope Skippers. They train for 9 to 10 hours a week and their fancy footwork won them the British Team Championships in 2005. But will they be able to achieve such impressive results with our motley crew?
At the end of today, our experts will be judging who's the daddy of Double Dutch, and the winner will get an all-important point. But will it be the girls or will it be the boys? Teams, are you ready?
Yeah!
I thought as much. Come on, let's go.
You're ready to learn some basic steps?
Yeah!
OK, Nicole's going to explain them then.
The first trick is basic jumping. Keep your legs together and jump up high.
So far, so good.
The second trick is speed steps. Keep your knees high in a running position.
Ooh, getting tricky.
The third trick is touching the floor. Make sure you're ready for the jump afterwards.
I'm not sure I can do that.
Who wants to go first?
Me!
First up, it's the boys, and Alex seems to have got right into the swing of things.
OK, do you want to try the speed step now?
That's a slightly unusual technique from Callum.
Set, go.
Josh has gone for the touchdown and he's got it. Nice one. Now for the girls, and Jessica's sure got the rhythm.
Hey, do you want to try touching the floor now? I'll call it.
You go, girl. Lucy's tying herself up in knots, but she gets there in the end.
Go.
Hannah needs a helping hand.
Close your eyes for a bit and then open your eyes, which feel you've got rhythm. And just kind of go like that, okay? So, set, go.
Looks like it's worked.
Okay, do you want to try the speed set then?
Finally, my turn. Check out my moves. They're impressed, I can tell. Or maybe not.
Well, Bobby, the time has now arrived. Please reveal who's the daddy of Double Dutch.
Well, Aisha, me and my team have been talking, and we've decided that today's winning team is... the boys!
Yeah!
There you go! You win the medallion, hold it with pride.
Let's remind ourselves of the boys' winning steps. Josh let his feet do the talking, while Alex was a natural.
The thing I found hardest was going down and coming back up again without getting trapped in the ropes.
Double dutching was really cool. I'm going to tell all my mates about it. They'll enjoy it.
It was difficult at first and I didn't think I'd be able to do it. But the team were cheering me on, so I tried really hard.
And as for me...
I am loving double dutch. I'm definitely going to keep it up and keep on practising my steps.
A win for the boys there, and if you fancy doing skipping as your DSD challenge, then do it and get on the website and tell us about it. bbc.co.uk/CBBC and click on DSD.
Right, it's a final Sam versus Mark challenge, and I don't know how it's happened, but Sam, you're winning 2-0.
Well, we've won, we're not winning, we've won.
You're winning 2-0.
Well,
but guys, it's all about honour. Yeah, nothing to do with winning.
Lads,
it's a taking part of
we're winning.
We've won.
So brilliant. Right, this is the big air challenge. Two teams, a member from each team, will ride down here on their respective mode of transport. They will get to their air shooters and they will fire them at the targets that we've got all along here. Once each member of the team gets a target down, they put their air shooters down, go to the back of the queue, and then the next member of the team comes down, and so on and so on.
Basically, the most targets you get down in the allotted time, you win.
Allotted?
Allotted.
Good word, word of the day.
Yeah.
The allotted time is 45 seconds. Okay, guys, are you ready?
Yeah!
Time on the clock, please.
3, 2, 1, go!
Go! Go!
I mean,
Okay, right. My team, I'm being honest, okay. I got 5.
Ooh! My team got 5.
Oh, what a shame you lost in first place anyway.
Well, Sam, you're up next now because you've only got one day before your hairdressing challenge and you've got a bit of dodgy design and you've got no speed and also, well, you've got no model either. Yeah. Basically, it's not coming down too well.
No, it doesn't sound like it.
Previously on DSD, Sam was challenged to enter an Afro barbering competition and complete a pattern of his own choice against the clock. But with only one day to go, he can't even find a model.
I don't suppose at all you'd fancy being a hair model, would you?
No, no.
And without one, Sam's challenge will be over. Do something different! Having been up all night, Sam believes he's got a winning design and he's hoping that Stephen, the salon owner, will be impressed.
Morning.
How you doing, man? You all right?
I went to see some Maoris. And basically they have loads of designs on their face and their biggest sort of designs is kind of swirls and like that. So, and I don't know why these sort of shapes, they were just kind of what's coming to my conclusion.
You didn't get no pictures at all, did you?
No pictures, no.
See, the thing is, they're good to actually start your practising on for a competition, too basic.
Right, okay.
Me personally, I want to go ahead and try and win.
With only a day left, Stephen is concerned that Sam won't have his new design in time, let alone get to practice shaving it onto someone's head.
If you can't do it and the pattern's not up to standard by Monday, then I'll have to do the pattern.
The competition rules state that one half of the relay team must perform a simple cut on one model before handing over to their partner, who shaves a more complex pattern onto the head of another. If Sam's design isn't up to standard, Stephen will relegate him to performing just the simple cut. Not wanting to fail his DSD challenge, it's back to the drawing board for Sam. He decides to take a risk and go for a completely different pattern design.
You'd do this for, say, a graphic design, say if you were at school, you'd do something, you'd draw your lines first to make it easier. Do the boxes, do the design inside it, and then you kind of rub out the lines that you don't need.
Sam settles for a simple statement which reflects his determination. I know I can.
Maybe the judges are looking for confidence as well, not just the fact of doing a design in the head and trying to make it neat and perfect.
But designing a pattern is only half of the battle. Sam still has to convince his mentors he's capable of shaving it onto someone's head at the competition.
Cheers, buddy. Have a good day. Thanks for me. Cheers.
I know I can.
It's positive.
That's all right.
Whilst his mentors discuss his exact role in the competition, Sam's determined to improve on his shaving skills.
Just finished my cut. I'm just going to see if they like it and see if I'm good enough to do it.
Sorry to interrupt you on air. Look, I just finished.
Nice. Very, very good, man. Yeah, well, we've made our decision now. And looking by that, you've got no worries about doing the pattern. No worries at all. You've relegated me to doing the straight haircut. That's what you've done. And I'm more than proud to say that that is going on there and we'll smash it. We will
smash it. Nice one. Thank you very much.
Having made the grade, Sam can breathe a massive sigh of relief.
It's been a tiring day today, I must admit, but it's been brilliant. I feel like I've achieved what I've wanted to achieve. I mean, I've actually done the task that I've got to do, really, so, which is brilliant. I know I can do it now, which is fantastic, so. Sorry, one second. Excuse me, sir. Sorry, mate, sorry to bother you, sorry.
Yeah.
Weird question, but sorry, could I just take a look at your hair one second?
My hair?
Yeah, sorry. I've been working in that salon over there for the past week and they've been training me how to cut people's hair.
Okay.
And tomorrow, I've got a competition to do. Basically, what I'm asking, I need a model. And if you wouldn't mind being the model.
Yeah, why not? Yeah?
But there's one final hurdle. Sam still needs to work on his speed if he's to complete his pattern in less than the 35 minutes he'll have in the competition. Stephen thinks he may have a solution.
Maybe a kitchen? Get me to a restaurant somewhere, make them chop up stuff quick. It's like, that's how we cut it, like that. Bam, 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 bam. Especially competition, it's all like this.
Hiya, I'm looking for Frank.
Frank?
Frank,
he's
yeah.
the chef.
Yeah. Fish cakes, ravioli, via.
Would you like to follow me or take you to Frank?
Okay, wicked.
A restaurant environment is full of pressure and relies on people working at high speed to produce as many as 15 plates of food per minute.
Rocketafella salad, please.
Sorry,
quickly, quickly, ring the bell, table four. And another fried squid, give me another plate exactly the same like that, please.
Okay.
Come on, mate, let's go, go, go.
Okay, okay, okay.
Quickly, quickly, four.
Oh, there you go. Timing, I think, definitely is the key qualities of this job and staying calm, under pressure.
Can you please keep the section clean, yeah? Look, I'm trying to make a salad, look, miss everywhere.
This is definitely helping towards me going, working fast, definitely.
Salad, salad, salad. Okay, I need three plates like this. I've asked you four times. I need them now, 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 now. Wait, 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 wait. You just slam the salad down, yeah, and it doesn't look good. I want a fresh plate. I think I've lost 5 years of my life tonight. Put the plates back.
Okay.
Sam, let's go. Wait, lemon salt, chocolate squeeze. Let's go. Somebody's getting the fire. I'd like to take him on board, actually.
Yeah, very much. Cheers.
Drink water.
Yeah.
Next time on DSD, having improved on his speed, it's competition day for Sam.
I really wish I'd have gone to the toilet.
Although there's a friendly face in the crowds, the judges are ruthless.
More from the man who can tomorrow.
You think I don't know that I know that I can?
You can. Tomorrow.
Coming up later on, you can see the second part of John's weather film.
And then, after that, it's the Beast!
The Beast! But that's later on. Right now, it's time for...
DSD of the day! Yeah.
Now, today's DSD challenge is a very simple one. We want you to form an orderly queue for no reason whatsoever.
Excellent. Here on DSD, we love a good queue, so get onto the website. You should be coming across the screen about now.
bbc.co.uk/CBBC and click on DSD.
Tell us about it.
Yeah, you could even film your queue if you want. You could take a photo of your queue if you want. You could send it in to us and you just might get on telly, just like this lot.
Nice one, guys. Well, if you like queuing, then make sure you go and DSD it if you really want to be standing in a very long queue. Now, I'm here with Sophie. She is my DSD co-host for the day. How's it going, Sophie?
Going really well, thanks.
Good. Well, I reckon now's a good enough time for us to get into another instalment of...
DSD Cast.
Oh, yeah. Now, so far, over 5,000 of you have already pledged to do a DSD. That's all well and good, but it means nothing. Zilch. Absolutely nada, unless you get online right now and let us know that you have done your DSD and be counted as one of the over 15,000 DSDs done so far. Sophie, what is the web address that they need?
All we need to do is log on to www.bbc.co.uk/CBBC and click on DSD. I had a go at drumming, what will your DSD be?
Exactly, and keeping with the music theme, we've got Drew in Kent who sent us in a video of him trying out the trumpet. Let's have a quick listen. Sounding lovely, Drew. So, Sophie, have you got a DSD update?
I do indeed. Yasmin from London sent us in this picture of her doing arts and crafts. Looks great, Yasmin.
It looks very nice, Yasmin, and make sure you send us in a picture of your final piece and we would love to see it. Now, if you want to have your DSD featured right here on DSD Cast, simply send in the video and your contact details to this address. DSD PO Box 48369, London W12 7UZ. You can also register your DSD on the phone. The number is 090 11 900 500. Calls will cost you 10p a minute from a BT landline. Mobiles and other networks will vary, and make sure you do get permission before you give us a call. And as ever, there's also plenty more exclusives on the red button. Right, that's the end of DSD Cast. I'm Aisha.
And I'm Sophie.
Right, now it's time to get back to Sam and Mark. Time to
unleash the beast.
Cheers for that, Aisha, and make sure you keep them DSDs coming in real nice.
Are you ready for the beast? Are you ready for me to unleash the beast?
Yeah, all right, I'm ready. Bring it on.
Now, wait. You've got to treat it with a bit of respect, because I've been fine-tuning this bad boy to send those water balloons into the atmosphere where those guys over there are going to catch them.
All right.
All right, now, all day, they've been working against each other. But now, for the purpose of this, they're going to be working together as a team against the beast.
The beast.
Now, the rules are pretty simple. They're going to be standing on the doormat of destiny.
Nice.
And they're going to try and catch as many as they possibly can.
OK.
Right, I'm going to call it wet ball.
Wet ball? It's a bit rubbish, isn't it?
Well, I didn't really have time to call it anything good.
Oh, all right then. Well, from now on, every wet ball Thursday, each team will only have 45 seconds to catch as many balloons as they can, but these balloons have to be intact. If they smash, that doesn't count, my friend.
No.
All right, are you ready?
Yeah.
All right.
Stand you by. Better be, because you're going to get wet.
OK, 45 seconds on the clock, please. Your time starts now. Oh, he dropped it. Oh, he got it. That's one core.
Nine!
Very respectable score, isn't it? And because these guys are the first team to do that, they get to go at the top of the leaderboard, which I've made, and I'm going to get it. I think you'll be impressed here. This is the leader balloon.
That's the leaderboard.
Leader balloon, Mark. Right, come on, put them on the top of it. They deserve it. Well done, lads.
Are you sure?
Yeah, come, Mark, right. We've wasted enough time. Come on, it's starting to rain.
Just
do it, will you?
All right.
Brilliant! Thanks a lot for that. I ain't got enough time to make another leader balloon, you know? What do you think I am? Some friend you are. Anyway, it's time to find out how John's getting on in his weather challenge.
Sorry.
11-year-old John has been set the DSD challenge of learning to be a weather presenter.
In just 2 weeks' time, you'll replace me and present the weather live on BBC Breakfast to more than a million people.
He's had a crash course in weather forecasting.
That's completely wrong.
He's been to the Navy to experience the effects of weather in a helicopter simulator.
Lima 1 lifting.
And in preparation for his live TV broadcast, John's about to present the weather for the first time to a room full of Royal Navy pilots. He's got to get it right. Their safety depends on it. John's about to give his first weather forecast to 30 pilots. With just an hour to prepare, he's starting to feel the pressure.
I'm nervous because if I say it's going to be sunny, they go to sunny, there's sunny gust, and they could knock the helicopter over and possibly kill someone.
It's the moment of truth. Will John be able to present his forecast, or will his nerves get the better of him?
Good afternoon, sir, A15. Welcome to the afternoon flying brief. First the Met, please.
As you can see, we've got a weather front just hitting the south of hitting France and just catching the south coast of England, bringing like showers. And then what we have our hazard.
Feeling the pressure, John's presentation begins to fall apart.
Level is at 10,000 feet, then breaking over class up to 8,000 to 12,000 feet. Sorry, so it's going to be quite a fair day.
As the pilots head off, Tom gives John some feedback.
When we are there in your briefing, we are your captive audience, so you can slow down and deliver the brief. And the best way to get the brief across is to look them square in the eye as you're giving them the brief to tell them what's happening with the weather. So if you're going to be giving forecasts in the future, enjoy it, slow down, and make sure you look at the camera or look at the person you're briefing to as well.
When I saw the room full of people, it was really nerve-wracking. Well, I just had my back to the wall just saying stuff really not professionally. You just go on like that once in a while.
It's clear John's got a lot of work to do if he's going to be ready for his DSD challenge. If he can't manage in front of just 30 people, how will he ever cope with over a million viewers on TV?
I'm realising now that 1 million live, 1 million live, 1 million live, 1 million live, it's getting to me now.
His mentor and weather presenter, Carol Kirkwood, shares her concerns.
Hello, John, this is Carol Kirkwood from the BBC. Now, what I've heard after the briefing that you gave to the Royal Navy Squadron is that you really do need to work on your presentation technique. What they said was that you were talking just a bit too quickly, so you need to really work on that and you need to slow down.
So Carol's called John into the BBC for some much-needed coaching.
You've had the Met training
And now you're going to get the presentation training because both of these are vital to deliver a really good weather forecast.
While John will do his actual forecast from the Blue Peter Garden, for now, Carol takes him to the studio to practice talking with pictures.
The first chart is your headline chart. So you'd say this weekend, it's going to become wet.
Over these past couple of days, it's been quite warm, but as you can see, it's becoming wet and cold over these next couple of days. Scotland's got some patchy rain and the highs of 24 degrees in London.
First of all, you need to speak much slower so that everybody can understand what you're saying. If you don't speak clearly and you speak quickly, you'll swallow your words so nobody will understand. So these are very important things, slow speech and clear speech. Right, John, so now you know what we've got to work on. So shall we go down to the Blue Peter Garden and have a wee bash?
Yeah.
Yeah, come on then.
Challenging is basically learning how to slow down and not keep my back to the audience, and basically that's it, and just learning, just keeping memory.
During a live broadcast, the presenter is wired up so the director can talk to them through an earpiece. This is something John is going to need to get the hang of for the big day.
Freedom of movement. So the exercise I want to do with you is for you to phone your dad, and whilst you're on the phone, I want you to keep talking, and I'm going to ask you to tell your dad something.
Tell him
about the graphics.
And by the way, you know them graphics they have, right?
Tell him you're going to keep talking. And then
we went all done, right? And like, he told us
there's an iris now in the pond.
My head just like it was like split in two because. I had one side, this ear, me dad, and one side, this ear to Carol, and it was all coming, punching in the middle, like exploding.
We're going to have to cut your time, so end your phone call now.
Okay, I've got to see that, Dad. Bye.
She said for the first time doing that, I did quite well. So, yeah, she was quite pleased when I'd done it quite well.
John might be feeling confident, but there's still a lot of work to do.
Okay, and cue John.
Next, he has to learn to talk to time, as on the day, he's got to keep his forecast within the time available.
It's going to be wet and cloudy for most of Tuesday.
One, time gone. You read to time, you talked to time, but now you need to get more oomph into your broadcast, okay?
Carol gives John some useful tips.
Your stance is also very important because that will make you look confident and authoritative. Practice in front of the mirror, okay?
It's going to be quite a rainy day. In high air, it's going to be quite snowy in the mountains, especially in the higher points in Scotland. I'm bringing some heavy cloud along with it.
Good. Now, what you said didn't make sense, but you looked good.
I wish you gave all the hints and tips. I felt all right. So okay. Well, I'll take that into consideration. I'll take that home and I'll practice that as well. So when I start practicing a lot, I get quite, I think to myself, right, I can do this. I think I can do this.
I do think he needs to take it perhaps just a little bit more seriously than he is. The other thing I think he needs to do definitely is talk much, much slower than he currently is.
Next time on DSD, will John learn to slow down and not stumble over his words?
It's going to be quite warming up. London's at about 24 degrees in that height.
Will he remember what he has to say and talk to time?
I can't believe it. 55 seconds, 0.72. That's slower than last time.
And how will he do when he finally delivers his forecast live on TV to over 1 million people?
I reckon he might be a bit, you know, oh my goodness. This is real. This is not playing anymore. This is real.
Yep, there's more from John's challenge film tomorrow.
Also tomorrow, make sure you get yourself 2 elastic bands so you can be part of a massive DSD challenge.
Yeah, big thank you to our DSDs today. Cheers, lads.
Nice one. We'll see you tomorrow when we'll be live.
You have been warned.
Bye! Bye.